Hello everyone, we have seen that how to create a client for the transfer manager and uploading a single file through transfer manager in using the S3 operations. Okay, so today we will see that how we can upload multiple files at once using the transfer manager in Amazon S3. So you are watching Smarty Tech Face. I am Anjali here to help you. So let's get started with today's topic. So what we have a file list. Okay, we are not talking about a single file. We have a number of files in this directory. So what we have done, firstly you need to provide the directory from where you want to upload. So what I am doing here, I have a directory and I have these three files to upload. You may want to upload all the files, or you may want to upload some files. Like I want to upload all the files, so I will provide the whole list of files. And if you want to some a few files only, so you can provide the list of file by giving the file in the list array. Okay, so what I want to, I just want to upload all the files which are in this directory. So I have provided the directory here and listing the file and making it as a array list. Fine. So now what we need to do, just use the transfer manager client dot. Now go to the upload part. So we have done with the single file upload. These four functions are for the single file upload, and another one is for directory. We will see it in the next few parts. And then we have a upload file list. These three functions are for the uploading file list. So if you are using this function, you need to just provide the bucket name, virtual directory. I will let you know what is that. And then file directory, then list of file. If you have some metadata to upload, you can use these two functions according to your convenience. So I'm using this one, which is very useful for you. So what we need to do, firstly we need to provide the bucket name. Whatever your bucket name is, just provide it here. I have a bucket name with this. Next, we need to provide the virtual directory key fix. If you will see the comments in this, you will see that it is just a key prefix. If you want to upload your file in some directory, internal nested directory, just provide the directory name here. If you do not provide to directory name, you can even provide the empty or null. You can see here the definition given is, You can use the null or empty string to upload the file to the root of the bucket. So I want to upload a bucket. Let's say I want to upload the bucket in test directory. Okay. Now what you need to do is, next you want to provide the directory. Directory here is where your files is now, which directory your files are having. I can see here from the properties, and this is my directory. Okay, so if we go to my code, you can see that I have already provided the directory here, and this will be by my directory from where I want to upload my files. So this is the directory. If you want to upload all files, I provide the list of files here. And if you want to upload some files from this directory, just provide it the name list, just add the list one by one. Okay, so I want the whole files to be uploaded. So this will be my file list. Okay, next what I need to do is just use the, okay, so this will be my transfer. So from transfer I will be using wait for completion and the show transfer progress, so that I will be able to know that if it is uploaded or not. And if it is not, it will wait for it to upload, because I am just shut down it after the completion of whole work. I have already told in the previous video what does that mean, that it will print the transfer of it, and it will just wait for all the transfer to be completed. Okay, so now it's done. So now run as Java application. and you can see now it is completed. So it is complete. How we will re-verify it? Either you can go to the S3 bucket and see if it is uploaded or not in this folder, okay, because we have provided a folder name to upload it. If you do not provide it, it will just upload it in the root directory. So I will check it using the download function. We have already seen the downloading of it. I will not explain it here. We will provide a next video for it, to that how to download the files. So just you can even copy it from here. So I will comment it out because I don't want to upload it again. So now what I have, I will provide file. I want to download a file in this file. If you will see my directory now, you will get to know that this is the file which I have provided. Here it is, Transfer Manager Test 3. Just mention it like XYZ and save it. Now it is saved, okay. Now what I am doing is, I am downloading a file that is Test 3, which was in my this directory upload, and I have already uploaded it using the multiple file upload of Transfer Manager. Now I want to download. So let's download. Now the test file, now test file should be converted into the test 3. Run as Java application. So now it is completed. Now go back to your test file, and this content, its content should be changed to this one, Transfer Manager test 3. Okay, go back, test. You can now see the test is converted into Transfer Manager Test 3. So that means our files are uploaded in the S3, and we have successfully uploaded the files using the Transfer Manager of S3 operations. So you can re-verify it using the download the single file or all the files as per your convenience, or you can use the different functions for downloading it. So we will see the download of directory and single file in the next part. So till then, take care, bye bye, and stay tuned, keep learning, keep watching.